Mount Everest in the Himalayas is the world's highest point, with an altitude of 29,032 feet above sea level. That's like 20 Empire State Buildings stacked on top of one another, including their spires and antennae. But perhaps surprisingly, the height of Mount Everest is changing. Is its place in the record books at risk? Hi, I'm Erin McCarthy, and today we're going to dive into the deepest caves, scale the tallest peaks, and try to keep our footing against the strongest winds on the planet as we run down some impressive geographical superlatives. Let's get started. Like other mountains around the world, Everest's elevation shifts due to plate tectonics and earthquakes. And there are long-standing arguments over snow height versus rock height. But even if it gains or loses a yard or two, Everest is not in danger of relinquishing its claim to fame anytime soon. The second highest point on Earth, the summit of K2 in the Karakoram Range, is only 28,251 feet above sea level. That's not to say that Everest is the tallest mountain on Earth. That honor belongs to Mauna Kea in Hawaii, which is a colossal dormant volcano. It rises 13,803 feet above sea level, which, you may be thinking, is less than half of the elevation of Mount Everest. But 60% of Mauna Kea is underwater. When factoring in its height from the seabed to the ocean surface, which is about 19,700 feet, the volcano's total height equals 33,503 feet. That's more than 6.3 miles from bottom to top. In fact, the largest mountains on the planet are the shield volcanoes that created the islands of Hawaii. Now let's come back down to Earth. Really far down. Like, to its lowest points. The shore of the Dead Sea, between Israel, Jordan, and the West Bank, is the lowest point on dry land at 1,400 feet below sea level. But that's nothing compared to the lowest natural point on Earth not under the ocean. In 2019, scientists mapping the bedrock underneath Antarctica's ice sheet announced they had located its deepest point in a canyon under the Denman Glacier, coming in at 11,500 feet below sea level. How low can we go? If we're talking about undersea superlatives, we can go much, much lower. The deepest point on the entire planet is in the western Pacific Ocean at the southern end of the Mariana Trench, which is itself a canyon in the seafloor. This spot, named Challenger Deep, is 36,000 feet below sea level, give or take a few hundred. That is so incredibly deep that the place wasn't explored until 1960, and just 27 people have dived to its bottom, one of whom was Titanic director and deep sea enthusiast James Cameron. The deepest lake on Earth is so isolated that a unique ecosystem and animal species have evolved in and around it over the past few million years. Lake Baikal in Siberia lies on a continental rift, a place where two tectonic plates meet. Over time, the plates have pulled away from each other, and water has filled the gap, forming the world's deepest lake at approximately 5,500 feet deep. It's also often called the world's oldest lake at about 25 million years old and holds 20% of all the fresh surface water on Earth. Baikal seals, the only seal species to live exclusively in fresh water, swim in its depths along with an exceptional number of plants and animals found nowhere else. But the world's biggest lake by surface area and volume? That's the Caspian Sea, a landlocked saline lake in Western Asia. It's a remnant of the ancient Paratatus Sea, which stretched from modern-day Central Europe to Central Asia, when it was cut off from larger oceans by the shifting of, you guessed it, tectonic plates. Today, the Caspian Sea covers more than 144,000 square miles, roughly the size of Montana, and contains 18,761 cubic miles of water. You know what really freaks me out? Cave diving. Imagine putting on your scuba gear and just heading downward, on and on and on, in total darkness. The only sound is your breathing. Yeah, it's not for me. But people often dive into the Hranice Abyss, the world's deepest freshwater cave system, located in the Czech Republic. In 2020, scientists estimated that the cave was up to 1 kilometer, or 3,280 feet, deep, which is twice as deep as previously thought. 4 years earlier, a professional cave diving team had sent an underwater ROV down to 1,325 feet, setting a world record, but had been stopped from further progress because they ran out of fiber optic cable. The deepest cave on Earth, though, is Veryavkhina in Abkhazia, which almost every country views as part of the country of Georgia, but Russia disagrees. Anyway, in 2018, after numerous expeditions over several decades, a team of spelunkers rappelled 1.3 miles down to the bottom. Veryavkhina is in a karst terrain, a type of formation mostly made of limestone that is easily worn away by water. The hydrological activity leaves behind sinkholes, springs, and long, twisting caves, perfect for people other than me to explore. Look, I saw the descent. You're not catching me in any cave system, ever. We can't move on to the next natural wonder without mentioning a key human-made superlative. In 1970, Soviet geologists began digging a hole into the frozen tundra near Murmansk in the Russian Arctic. Over the next couple decades, they continued drilling through never-before-seen layers of Earth's crust in an effort to understand its makeup, eventually reaching a record depth of 40,230 feet before funding ran out. Ownership of the Kola Super Deep Borehole SG3, catchy name, changed hands a few times until the site was abandoned in 2008. But don't worry, any hapless explorer who comes upon it won't fall in, even if they manage to pry open the cover that was put on. Which, don't do that. Though it's still the world's deepest man-made hole at 7.5 miles below the surface of the Earth, it's only 9 inches in diameter. Just don't drop your phone down it. I don't think insurance covers that. Which river holds the title of the world's longest is surprisingly controversial. The top two contenders have always been the Nile and the Amazon, but as scientists have learned more about their geography and refined their measurement methods, the crown has been passed from one river to the other more than once. The United States Geological Survey, and perhaps more importantly, Guinness World Records, maintain that the Nile is the world's longest river at 4,132 miles and 4,160 miles, respectively, edging out the 4,000-mile Amazon. However, researchers in Brazil, where the Amazon size is a point of national pride, claim that the Amazon is actually 4,344 miles long and the Nile a mere 4,258. Will the rivalry ever be settled? Maybe. An expedition to map the entire length of the Amazon by kayak is launching this year, so we may get an answer. The expedition is set to start off from the Amazon's natal stream in the Andes, which happens to be the world's longest mountain range on land. The world's longest mountain range, period, is the mid-ocean ridge, which snakes through every ocean for a total of 40,389 miles. The Andes span 5,500 miles, according to Encyclopedia Britannica, and stretch from Tierra del Fuego at the southernmost point of South America up the Pacific coast to Venezuela on the Caribbean Sea. The range is second only to the Himalayan mountain system in height, and several Andean mountains are also superlatives. Aconcagua in Argentina is the world's highest mountain outside Asia at 22,837 feet. The summit of Mount Chimborazo in Ecuador is the farthest point from Earth's center thanks to Earth's bulging shape at the equator. And the highest volcano above sea level on the planet is Nevado's Ojos del Salado on the border of Chile and Argentina. The lowest temperature ever recorded was observed on July 21, 1983 at the Soviet Union's Vostok station in the dead of austral winter. The snow surface temperature plunged to negative 128.6 degrees Fahrenheit, which is so cold that I don't know anyone who's lived to report the details. The residents of Oymyakon, Russia, have the distinction of living in the coldest permanently inhabited place on Earth, where the average winter temperature plummets to negative 58 degrees Fahrenheit. That's several important degrees shy of its official winter temperature record of negative 90 degrees Fahrenheit, observed on February 6, 1933 at the town's weather station. Road trip, anyone? On the other end of the spectrum, the hottest temperature ever recorded was an absolutely scorching 134 degrees Fahrenheit at the aptly named Furnace Creek in California on July 10, 1913. This blistering spot lies 190 feet below sea level and hosts a visitor center for Death Valley National Park. If you haven't kept up on your weather world records, you might think a much hotter temperature was recorded in what is now Libya in 1922. But a few years ago, a World Meteorological Organization commission decided that that record was invalid. I bring this up because some of the same people think the 1913 Death Valley record is completely bogus as well, though there's been little desire to put together another commission to investigate, so it remains the official record. But even if that particular record is dubious, Death Valley still probably has the title, just for a different date and temperature. The place with the hottest average annual temperature sounds only mildly cooler. A mining company working in Dalal, Ethiopia, recorded temperature data between 1960 and 1966 that showed an annual average temp of 94 degrees Fahrenheit. Dalal is located in the Danakil Depression, an otherworldly corner of the country where three tectonic plates diverge, bringing live volcanoes, sulfur springs, mineralated geysers, and vast salt plains to the surface. The hottest areas on the planet are also some of the driest, with annual rainfall measured in mere millimeters. The world record for the longest period without precipitation occurred in Arica, Chile, between October 10, 1903 and January 1, 1918. That's more than 14 years without a drop. Meteorologists measure acute rainfall in intervals ranging from 1 minute to 96 hours, which result in some pretty spectacular precipitation records. The tiny hamlet of Unionville, Maryland, takes the title for most rainfall in a 1 minute period, receiving 1.23 inches on July 4, 1956. Two locales of the Indian Ocean on Reunion hold records for the most rain in 12, 24, 72, and 96 hours. Between February 24th and 27th, 2007, more than 16 feet of rain fell on one of the island's volcanic craters. Cherrapunji, India, experienced the most rainfall in a year anywhere on Earth, From 1860 to 1861, more than 86 feet of water inundated the town. But none of these places is technically the world's wettest spot. That honor goes to Masaram, India, only 10 miles away from Cherrapunji as the crow flies. From 1941 to 1979, it averaged almost 39 feet of precipitation a year. Finally, let's look at the world wind records. The strongest gust of wind ever recorded blew through Barrow Island, Australia as part of Tropical Cyclone Olivia on April 10, 1996. It clocked 253 miles per hour. When it comes to tornadoes, the superlatives are even more shocking. The wind speed of a May 1999 tornado in central Oklahoma reached a truly incredible 302 miles per hour. That storm undoubtedly carried tons of debris far and wide. And believe it or not, the World Meteorological Organization has a category for that too. The record for longest tornado transport, indicating the greatest distance that a tornado ever carried an object, was set on April 11, 1991. A powerful tornado whisked a personal check 223 miles from Stockton, Kansas to Winnetoon, Nebraska. No word on whether it ever got cached. Thank you for watching this episode of The List Show. Which superlative was the most surprising to you? I personally am still too distracted by the horrifying concept of underwater cave diving to think about anything else. It's just so dark and claustrophobic, and there could be weird fish in there. Well, I'm not sleeping tonight. I'll see you next time.